Hi everyone, welcome back to the Cat Kings NMAT Daily. This is Anisha here and I'm going to be taking you guys through a very important topic today, which is like if I look at the last entire week that has been the plight for maximum students, how to maximize your scores in the quants section, right? So that's been like the pain area for everybody. Everybody's scoring around 40s, 50s, 60s and our target is to look at a 70 plus in quant section. I mean, I would say target a 90 score, right? If you want to be very sure, very safe of clearing sectional cutoffs for Mumbai. So we have to keep that in mind, right? So if I look at, you know, the focus area of quants, what is coming? If you look at it, this is something I would have told you all even in your day one analysis. Minimum 3 DI sets everybody has got. So 3 DI sets for sure. Fourth DI set, if you are getting, that means you scored well in quants, your adaptive level has raised, and that is why it's giving you a fourth DI set, which is going to be crazy calculation intensive. And all the people who have done 4 DI sets have ended up getting a score of 230, 240 plus, okay? So keep that as your benchmark in your mind. Then when I look at the quant section, most important, arithmetic, 65% weightage is to arithmetic. Then we have our modern maths. Then we have our log-based questions. Log-based questions are not very difficult, time-consuming. They're actually direct formula-based application questions. Okay? And numbers may say, if you see remainder theorem, ka one question had come, or at max two questions in like one-off situations. So if I look at it, I have to clear this up. I have to make sure my DI is strong. 3 DI sets is 12 questions, right? So for that, what you have to do is practice. Practice day in and out, 5 sets of DI, sit with a stopwatch, let yourself get used to the time ticking. Stopwatch, not the time left. You need to train yourself for that time left, okay? So do that for DI, 5 sets of practice every day. Data sufficiency, again, is a score boosting area, 4 to 6 questions. So aapka NMAT official guide, Cat King NMAT maximizer books, finish all the data sufficiency questions in this. Ye bhi khatam ho gaya hai, to do the GMAT official guide and finish up all your mock tests. Theek hai? So that is one thing. Then the most important area, which is the most neglected section by everybody, is your modern maths. I don't know, it's the most hated section. Majority people hate permutation, combination, probability. Trust me, it's a very interesting area. You just need to understand the fundas, understand conceptually. Okay? I'm going to teach you all one very basic short one technique. If you are able to understand this, then start telling yourself, I don't hate modern maths. I don't hate PNC probability and I can do that. Okay? So let me see if you guys remember this formula. Remember? NCR is equal to N factorial upon R factorial into N minus R factorial. Then we have NPR, which is again N factorial upon N minus R factorial. Remember these formulas? When do we use them? I'm sure you would have read in all the books and everything is. NCR is when we're making a selection. NPR is when we're making an arrangement. This is what PNC essentially is. Okay, these two formulas rakh sakte ho. But fayda nahi. You need to understand usage. You need to understand application, right? So I personally don't like ratta maroing formulas at all. So isko hum thoda time ke liye, keep it park it aside. We will study something called as principle of counting. Theek hai? Imagine I'm giving you guys 3 pens and 2 markers. You have 3 pens with you and 2 markers with you. And I ask you a question. Pick any one out of these. That means you have how many options? You have with you 3 options of pen. You can choose either one pen from the 3 options of pens, or you can choose any one of the markers. How many markers we had? 2 markers. So that means I have 3 ways in which I can select a pen, or 2 ways in which I can select a marker. Whenever there is or, remember, or stands for addition. Theek hai? Either this or that. So it becomes 3 plus 2, which is 5 ways. Okay? Now, that's what your answer is. NCR, NPR, zarurat hi nahi hai, right? Next question, if I ask you, out of these 3 pens and 2 markers, I want you to pick out 1 pen and 1 marker. To select 1 pen, I had how many options? 3 options, 3 ways. and one marker, two ways. So now it's and. And means multiplication. So I have three ways to select a pen and two ways to select a marker. I multiply these, 3 into 2 gives me 6 ways, right? This is what your basic principle of counting is. Very simple example I have taught you guys. Use this in every possible question of PNC and probability. PNC will become easier for you. Okay? So try this out. In fact, we have a lot of such more interesting techniques which are taught in your concept builder videos and advanced lesson videos on the Cat Kings dashboard. So get access to the same. Get on board with the NMAT Turbo online course, and I'll be teaching you a lot more techniques in my NMAT Thursday sessions. We'll discuss strategies, we'll give mock tests, analyze your scores, and at the same time, look forward for maximizing our attempts and getting through NMAMS. All right, all the best. Bye-bye, take care.